The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Hi students, welcome back. I am very happy to see you all in our virtual exam. I am happy to see that you have done very well. Okay, and one thing, all of us, they are going outside for playing and some other activities. Be safe, dears. Otherwise, it will be creating problems to your parents and you. Okay, use mask and sanitizers while going outside and play with your friends by keeping a distance. Okay, dears, don't go outside frequently. Okay, so listen, we are going for the next chapter, third chapter. So the first and second chapter deals with the different topics. The first one, it is about an image editing software, GIMP. And the second chapter is about how you can create a document and how you can arrange the contents in different layouts, is it? So let's see the next chapter, what it is. Here it is, the chapter 3, the infinite world within our grasp. While seeing the title, you will get an idea. What is that? Can you say something about? While seeing the picture, can you get any idea? Yes, you are getting a mail. That girl is receiving a particular mail. That means a message, is it? So, by the name, world within our grasp, that means related to internet, is it? So, related with the internet and we are sending some messages, is it? What is that? Yes, you people know about that. That is email. Clear? So in this chapter, we are going to study about how to send an email, how to create an email account and how we can create the different messages type. Okay. And different service providers too. Clear? So here, let's see what is an email. Email means it is a short form of electronic mail. Mail means it is a letter. That is electronic letters mean what is that? While using the internet and the computers, you are sending the mail. Okay, email is a short form of electronic mail. By using an electronic devices and system, you are sending the email. That is, it is a method of sending and receiving messages through internet using an electronic medium. Okay, and what are the different type of contents you can send through this? That is, you can send and receive pictures, audios, videos and different document types. You know about, is it? It is a common thing nowadays. And next is how we can create an email account. For sending an email, you should have an email account, is it? In different service provider, it is available. So generally, we are using the Gmail, that is from Google, is it? So for creating an account in Gmail, how you can do that? So first of all, you have to open the site. That is, in Google, you have an option as Gmail. So while clicking on Gmail, you will get the dialog box or a window like this. Okay, in this, you can click on here, sign in. If you already have an email, you can go through that sign in. Okay, and if you want to create a new email, means you have the option create a new email or a new ID. Okay, so by clicking, you will get the sign in option here. You have to create an account, means you have an option create account. By clicking create account, you will get in a box like this. Can you see that? Here you have to give your details. How to? What are the details you have to use? That is the first name. What is? And the last name you have to enter and the user ID. This is your user ID section. You can enter any type of user ID like this. So generally, the normal format of your an email ID is your name. With your name, you have to use in any symbols or any other part. Sometimes the particular name it will be repeating in an our Gmail server. So you can use any different type of sections. You can include the numbers or any symbols using this option. And after that, typing the username and you have to provide some password. Okay, and you have to confirm the password. So it should have a format. Use 8 or more characters with a mix of letters and numbers and symbols. So the password must be a security provider. So it should be very strong. No one can easily predict the particular password. If I am creating a user ID and I am giving the password as Priya or BSS or like this means, someone can easily identify or someone can easily predict what password I can. Or by the date of birth or anything. Okay. So don't give such passwords. Use a mix of letters and symbols and your characters. And you should remember. Okay. After typing these details, you can click next. And after clicking next button, you will get the option to verify your Google account. Okay, no one should create an illegal Gmail account. So, for the security reason, Google have provided the particular section to identify who is the user. So, you should give a phone number or the alternate email ID. So, you will get an identification or OTP, one-time password to check if you have created an legal Gmail ID. Okay. So after this, you will get a message. So after this, you will get a message, your account is created. That is created and you can enter into your Gmail account through your username and password. Okay. So let's see what are the main parts in a Gmail ID. So generally, an email address has two parts. One is the username and the other one is the service provider, and it is separated with the at symbol. Okay, for example, here you can see an email ID for Joy Cheria. Okay, here it is Joy Cheria, and it is a username, and Gmail is a user service provider, and at symbol which separating the username and service provider. Okay, and we have different service providers like Yahoo, Docking and another email service providers. So same it is. It's every service provider has the same format. Okay. That is username and service provider name and it is separated with the at symbol. Clear? Yes. And next is after entering into the or signing button, you will get the option as like this. You have to type that security letters. If it is not in the same format, it will not enter into your email ID. So what such security content? It is known as CAPTCHA. What is that? Completely automated public Turing test. The computer or the server, it will be automatically checking if it is a human being or another software. So if it is a human being means, he can identify the letters and the symbols. If it is a software means, it will not identify such contents. So that is the particular automated test to check whether it is human or any other software. If anyone is hacking means they are using some software. So for the security reason only, they have created such idea. So what is its full form? Completely automated public Turing test. Clear? It is known as CAPTCHA. Okay students, while using the Gmail ID, you should be very careful. Don't enter your contents into any other or illegal websites or any unavailable, that is unknown websites. Clear?
Yes.
So by using your email ID, they can easily find out your WhatsApp contacts and everything. Okay, so be careful by using your Gmail ID. Clear? And this CAPTCHA is used to ensure that it is a human being or not. The lab we have already discussed about, is it? So this CAPTCHA is generally used in different websites also. While downloading your any MP3 or any videos, you can see that, is it? So this is a particular security checking options in a website. Clear, students? So how to send an email? I think you all know about that, how to send an email in a Gmail account, is it? So while seeing this, you will get an idea, is it? This is an Gmail account. You can see the options inbox, that is the message you can see in a particular inbox. And if you want to any star email, that is in favorite contents, means you can star the options. And here it is send mail. What are the mails you have? How many mails you have sent, means it will be seen in a send mail option. So here you have an option, it is compose. While clicking, you will get a dialog box like this. Here you will get a new message box. Here you can type to address where whom you have to send the email, and from, that is automatically it will be displayed, that is your email ID. And subject, if you have to send any PPT, means you have to write PPT or whatever it is, like your according to your subjects. And you have to write some messages, means you can write in the contents. Okay, and if you need to attach any files, means you have an option here. If you have to send some images or any videos, means you can see here. Here you can see an option. Can you see that? Here you have an option is attachment. Generally you know about, all are using the WhatsApp and you are sending some contacts, is it? So same format. Here Smiley and Google Drive options. Generally images and different options are available. If you want to attach any content, means attach the content. And finally, you will have the option send. Okay students, so like this you have to attach the contents and everything, and you can write the any messages, means you can include your messages here and click send file. Okay, so I think you have clear about the how to create an email ID and how to send the messages and how to create it and how to attach a new file also. Clear? So let's go for an activity. We have a different method of communication, is it? So one is letter. What is the merit and demerit? That is normal. You are using it. Any courier service or any post office or like that. Okay. And next one is telephone. What is the merit and demerit? Clear? How to communicate and what are the different options available in this section. And what are the different mode of communication? You have to think and try. So complete this activity, and also you have to write these steps in your notebook. Most of you are not following the steps and the activity, is it? So everyone should write the activity from this first slide. Write the each and every options we have provided in the slide and complete this activity too. Okay students, so I think you have understood the content. If you have any doubts, please contact. And keep in mind, don't go outside frequently. Be safe. Nowadays it is very tough situation is going on. So be safe. Stay healthy. Goodbye.